dear student and family member of Kamala Nehru Higher Secondary School. Good morning and namaskar to all. I extend my warm greeting on this special occasion of Indian Independence Day. युग युग की शांति अहिंसा का लेकर प्रयोग गरिमा समस्त इतिहास नया लिखने आया यह पुण्य पर्व 15 अगस्त 15 अगस्त त्यौहार राष्ट्र के चिरपरिचित अरमानों का 15 अगस्त त्यौहार अनगिनत मूक मुग्ध बलिदानों का एज वी सेलिब्रेट दिस डे विद ग्रेट जॉय एंड जुबिलेशन वी ऑल्सो नीड टू पे ट्रिब्यूट टू दोज हु फॉट टायरलेसली टू अचीव दिस फ्रीडम एंड टू दोज who shaped the destiny of this country with their vision and wisdom. Being an Indian, it is no less than an honor to address you all on this special occasion of our great country. And on this moment, I would like to share my notions with you. As we know that India celebrates its Independence Day on 15th August every year since India won her freedom from the foreign rule in 1947 and became a sovereign nation. That moment ended 3 centuries British colonial rule. The land was no longer summer retreat for Britishers. It was the end of nearly century-long struggle for freedom, battles, betrayal and sacrifices. It created a situation where we were responsible for ourselves. But now, India is valued for its flourishing economy, investment opportunities, and rich cultural heritage. We are now attempting to become the nation it was envisioned to be. A free country where differences are respected and preserved, where natural resources are complemented by technological advancement and where the potential of its people is acknowledged and realized also. But transformation is not complete. Disparities exist among our people in our country. Corruption is common and poverty still looms large. All this would suggest that we are yet to liberate freedom from many ills. Freedom, Azadi, Swatantrata. What does this word mean to us? Our generation got freedom absolutely free, and I think it is taking it for granted. Actually, most of us today have no idea what it takes to live as subject of foreign power. It is only because of our courageous freedom fighters we had been born free. Being born in a free country, living and breathing in free air is privilege. It is a gift for us which been given to our great freedom fighters. Now, so it is time to be respectful to all those freedom fighters who fought for our nation's life rather than their personal lives. According to me, freedom is when you are able to live just the way you wish to. It is liberty that we have at various levels. We have liberty to express ourselves, but same time I feel freedom is moreover great responsibility to just hold all expectations, dreams with care and to mold those responsibilities and dreams in the better way to just get better future. Now it's time to bring positive changes and make growth more organized, more better conceptualized, scientific and well distributed in every sphere of our society. If we see, today the freedom has ever widening meaning, not just limited the word Swaraj. It is a freedom that makes a society open and accepting, demands a fair and responsible government and assures the poor and marginalized that they will be heard. And the onus is now on us to achieve this kind of freedom. It is not an impossible goal. We know that. We know our capacity to rally and revive ourselves has been proven time and again. We can just get better by understanding what divides us. We can discard that thing. By creating a healthy atmosphere for voicing our opinions, by doing our bit to improve lives of underprivileged, and by appreciating all Indian, irrespective of differences, we can actualize the dream of an India as seen by our great freedom fighters. The great poet and philosopher Rabindranath Tagore had dreamed for this kind of destiny for young India, where the mind is free from fear and head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into small fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come from the depth of the truth, where tireless striving stretches its arm towards perfection, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and actions. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my nation away. So this is the dream of each and everybody, and we have to take this forward. We have to learn from the past, think for the future, and live for the present. Only then India can become a progressive country. India is held together not by a common ethnicity, but an idea, the idea of unity in diversity, where people, however different from one another, but they can coexist peacefully and flourish. We as Indian are resilient country, and countrymen, we are warm, enterprising and almost every sphere of the world, and with the young people taking the reins in the political and social sphere, we will soon be right on top of the world. With this hope, I believe that we all together will work for the betterment of our country, and in current scenario, in this difficult time of COVID-19, our responsibility to behave a free Indian is more. We have to care each other, we have to respect each other, and we have to follow laws and guidelines so that we can just secure safe and better environment for each and every citizen. With this hope, once again, I wish you all happy Independence Day. आजादी का पर्व यह देता है सौगंध, सभी रहें सद्भाव से स्नेहिल हो संबंध, यह स्वतंत्र भारत तभी बना रहेगा भव्य, अधिकारों के साथ में करें सभी कर्तव्य। जय हिंद, जय भारत।